Scream Queens premiered September 22, 2015 on Fox. The slasher comedy featured an incredible ensemble cast, including Jamie Lee Curtis, Emma Roberts, Kiki Palmer, and incredible guest stars like Niecy Nash and Ariana Grande. Although the show initially received mixed reviews and its ratings steadily decreased throughout season one, the fans that were gathered were very devoted. To much surprise, Scream Queens was renewed for a second season on January 15th, 2016. The second season, which switched settings from season 1's sorority house to a hospital setting, was actually more well received by critics. However, a lot of fans were not the biggest fan of this season. This could be due to the time jump, the setting switch, or the narrative focusing less on the whodunit aspects like season 1 did. Ratings for the second season were unfortunate, and to no one's shock, Scream Queens was canceled at Fox after two seasons on May 15th, 2017. Fans, like myself, were upset. However, given that the show was not a success when it comes to network television, we weren't surprised. Ever since the cancellation, Ryan Murphy has not spoken about the show. Its cast moved on to other projects, and everyone seemed to move on, besides the fans. That was until Sunday, February 3rd, 2019. Out of nowhere, Ryan Murphy posted the following post on Instagram. He writes, "So many people have recently been asking me about the rebooting or continuing of Scream Queens. Rest in peace, taken too soon. Emma Roberts, Billy Lord, Leah Michelle, and I have mused on it, but question. Should it be a 6-episode limited series, a catch-up movie, and who should I bring back?" So basically what this post means is that Ryan has been given an opportunity to bring this show back in some way, and I'll get more into that in a second. But basically the two options on his mind are a 6-episode limited series, which would act as a season 3, probably on Netflix, or a full-on movie, which would probably also be on Netflix. I honestly have not experienced such a large sense of hope in a long time, and if you haven't guessed, Scream Queens has been and will probably always be my favorite show, so I was completely ecstatic. Emma Roberts, aka Chanel Oberlin, commented on the post saying, "Long live Chanel." Leah Michelle, also known as Hester or Chanel No. 6, commented, "Long live Hester." Niecy Nash, also known as the iconic Denise Hemphill, liked and commented, expressing her interest in returning. Jerry O'Connell, who played Dr. Mike in season 2's flashback scenes, expressed his approval in reviving the show. Emma Roberts, Leah Michelle, and Glenn Powell, who played Chad Radwell, also liked the post on Instagram. Chanel No. 2, played by none other than Ariana Grande, also liked the Instagram post. John Stamos also liked the post, but you know how I feel about Brock Holt, so let's pretend he didn't. So it's safe to say that although not all of these characters are sure to appear, there's still a chance that a lot of the original cast will return. I mean, just look at all the interest on this Instagram post alone. It has become Ryan's most liked Instagram post since November and is still counting. By far, this is his most commented on post of any that I could see. I looked back on his apocalypse announcement, his cult announcement, and this easily blows those out of the water in terms of comments. So it's safe to say that the cast is really interested and the public is really interested as well. Because, you know, it's been a couple years since the show last aired and it's been on Hulu ever since, so it's safe to assume that the show has garnered a lot more fans than it had in its original run. As SQ News Updates on Twitter noted, Lauren Bott, a costume designer, reposted this post with the hashtag Season 3. Okay, so this post seems kind of like it's spur of the moment, right? They probably haven't set any filming dates or anything, unless they have. SQ News Updates on Twitter also pointed to an interview with Emma Roberts from January. In the clip, Emma Roberts notes that she's doing something with Ryan Murphy at the end of the year.
He's the best. I mean, when he called me 6 years ago and was like, "Do you want to be on one of my shows?" I literally screamed and put the phone on mute and then was like, "Maybe, tell me more." No, I've just been so happy that he's kept me around, and it seems like I'll be doing something else with him at the end of the year, so I'm really excited.
You may think, oh, she's probably referring to another American Horror Story season, and yeah, maybe, but doesn't this seem a little too sly to just be her hinting at another American Horror Story role?
It seems like I'll be doing something else with him at the end of the year, so I'm really excited.
It wouldn't be completely shocking if she was to return in American Horror Story, so why not just say, oh, I'm probably going to be doing American Horror Story, because we know Billy Eichner and Sarah Paulson have been basically saying that on talk shows. But that kind of makes me think that she is referring to this Scream Queens project. Also, American Horror Story films in the summer, so she isn't referring to American Horror Story unless she misspoke and meant to say later this year, not at the end of the year. because at the end of the year, they've completely wrapped the 9th season of American Horror Story. So does this mean Scream Queens season 3 or a Scream Queens movie will be filming late 2019 for a 2020 release? That's what I think. And I think this Instagram post was a clever way to build up hype, and he actually does have a larger idea of how and when he is going to do this project. It appears that Ryan and the cast may have a complete idea on what they're doing, and Emma Roberts, Lea Michele, and Billie Lourd are all but confirmed to return. Now let's talk what medium this reboot might fall in. So as you may know, Scream Queens is a trademark of 20th Century Fox because that is who distributed the show and that's who produced it and all that. It was on their network. But Ryan is still friendly with 20th Century Fox. He has several shows still airing on their networks, which are Fox and FX. You know, you got Pose, you got American Horror Story, American Crime Story, and he's got 9-1-1. But Ryan recently also struck an infamous $300 million deal with Netflix, which seems like the perfect place for television reboots and reunions. Fox still owns the trademark for Scream Queens, but given Ryan's relationship, I believe they can strike a deal for the production of season 3. If Ryan didn't think he could strike a deal with 20th Century Fox to get the rights to Scream Queens back to Netflix, I do not think he would be posting about this, so I don't think this is a problem at all. But I definitely think this new project will air on Netflix. Personally, I hope they go for the limited series direction. I would love a full 13-episode season or even 10 like the second season, but I could see 6 episodes working. Especially on Netflix, where each episode can be however the hell long they want it to be. They don't have commercial time to fill up, and so the episodes could be like an hour and a half long, and I'm completely fine with that. The more, the merrier. So if you think about it like that, the runtime could actually be equal to the second season. But if they do go with the movie direction, I feel like it would be kind of hard to wrap all of these iconic characters, and I feel like that's all the movie would end up being, and that's not necessarily what I want if we're bringing these characters back. I don't want this little thing that wraps up all the characters' stories. I want another mystery. I want another serial killer to be after these characters. So this would be too difficult to do both tasks in under 2 hours, so a limited series would definitely be the best direction. And if you're thinking about budget, Scream Queens doesn't necessarily need the biggest budget. We don't need these large set pieces, we just really need these characters, and I know these are big names, so it does need budget to make that happen, but Netflix seems to not care about where their money goes. They're making these huge movies with these huge names. I think they can spare the budget for a Scream Queens limited series. I think Scream Queens was way ahead of its time, and I think Netflix is the perfect place to put a show like Scream Queens. It's got such a specific demographic, and not everybody's gonna like it, but the people that do like it, they love it. Like, it's such a specific audience, which you may think is bad for a TV show, but it's great for Netflix, where there's so many different shows on Netflix for different types of people, and this show captures a certain group of people, as you know, because you're probably one of them if you're watching this video, that latch on to these characters and these campy stories and the serial killer aspect of it and the mystery and all the drama and the comedy. They latch onto it, and honestly, it's like the perfect show for these people. And it's the perfect show for Netflix. Like, I understand why it didn't succeed on Fox. It could succeed on FX, but it will have the most success on Netflix. But I have a whole video written about what I would want from season 3 if we're talking about plot elements, so I won't focus on the plot in this video. But just a side note, Jamie Lee Curtis needs to return, even if it's just for a cameo. Ryan Murphy made the show for Jamie Lee Curtis, so it would feel a little off if he continued it without her. Now, I know she's busy and I know she might want to focus on other things, but I do know she does have a relationship with Ryan Murphy. I don't know how extensive it is, but I think Ryan can convince her to come back. I'd be fine with a cameo, but I would obviously love for her to have a large role. I'd love for all of the original cast to have a large role, and even some of the guest stars like Niecy Nash, she needs to be in it. But anyway, if Scream Queens really films late 2019, I would expect a summer or fall 2020 release date. You know, this is just speculation, but I hope with every ounce of hope in me that this works out. Even if it's not what everybody wants it to be, and some people can't return, and the plot maybe not what everybody envisioned, I would be elated to revisit these characters in this world no matter what. I know a lot of people didn't like second season, and I admit that the second season is a little bit of a drop in quality from the first season, but they obviously went two different directions with them, and I honestly love them both. So even if this isn't the most amazing thing in the world, I would be the happiest person to watch it, because I honestly thought this would never happen. Like, you guys know how much I love American Horror Story, but like, I loved Scream Queens. It was like the perfect show that was made specifically for me. It takes every single aspect of TV that I love and it puts it into one show. So I'm honestly the most excited person about this. Like I thought it would be like impossible for this to even happen with all the cast members. And I know it's just a lot to think about and I really hope it works out. And if Ryan Murphy is really interested in the show again, like he was with the first season, I think they can do some amazing things with it. Because, you know, it's rumored that Ryan kind of lost interest and wasn't really all hands on deck for season two like he was with season one. And that could kind of be what caused the kind of tone shift and stark difference between season one and season two. But if Ryan is really all hands on deck on this like he was with season one, it could be everything we need. Alright, so I just wanted to update you all on the amazing news and speculate about the possible production schedule. Of course, there's still a chance that this may not work out, but with all of these cast members and Ryan himself interested, I think it's pretty safe to say that we have not seen the last of the Chanels. Alright, so give this video a like and make sure you subscribe for more Scream Queens news and theories. I have a bunch of Scream Queens videos that I've written like throughout the past like 6 months that I've been doing this YouTube channel that I haven't put out, but I think this news kind of maybe hopefully put a spark in the fandom and maybe re-piqued interest. But I'll also of course be updating on American Horror Story Season 9 and every Ryan Murphy news that comes out, so make sure you subscribe. And also, thank you guys so much for sticking around during my 2 month hiatus. Honestly, only Scream Queens could pull me out of my retirement, but I'm so glad it did, and I hope to be back for good now. All right, thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.